In 1987, astronomers saw a star they had never seen before. The star, about 15 times larger than our sun, was collapsing on itself, creating one of the most awesome events in our universe, a supernova. Scientists were able to capture just a small amount of information from that supernova, but when the next one occurs, they hope to capture much more data, with help from UC Davis.
Supernova are stars that are near the end of their life that eventually explode. They're massive enough that their core collapses and they produce this giant explosion. And along with that explosion, they also produce neutrinos. The neutrinos carry all the information of that explosion with them as they travel through outer space and directly to Earth. By measuring the neutrinos and their energy, we can get a very, very good hindsight measurement of what happened inside the supernova when it exploded at that very instant.
These stellar explosions have a lot of information on how our galaxy was formed and how the solar system came to look like it does today. So one of the things that keeps us from doing that right now is a lack of knowledge on how many, for the neutrinos that we're trying to measure, a lack of knowledge on how many times you might see things that look like neutrinos that aren't. And so this experiment will determine how often that happens. And so we can figure out when we actually measure the radiation coming from the star, how many of are actually neutrinos, how many of are just the normal stuff that's happening here on Earth.
We're working on an experiment here called BACON, which stands for Bucket of Argon Counting Neutrons. And the goal of this experiment is to measure neutron reactions in argon. This experiment here is a replica of a much larger experiment being built in South Dakota, which will also be filled with argon. And this larger experiment hopes to detect neutrinos from supernova. But one of the backgrounds that could cause an uncertainty in this measurement are produced from neutrons interacting in argon. So that's what our goal is here, is to measure those backgrounds with high precision and accuracy. It puts UC Davis on the map as one of the unique cyclotron facilities in the United States that can do this type of experiment. A lot of the beams that exist, not all of them can tune their beam energies. So, you know, this makes for a wide variety of neutron interactions that you can study, because you can choose what energy you wanna look at. And it's also nice because for our group, it's easy access for us to come over and work hands-on with both students and visitors on this experiment. And I think that's really good for UC Davis in the research field and fundamental science.